In this video, we'll show you how the modify request body rule works in Requestly and how you can use it to modify the body of an outgoing HTTP request, whether it's to tweak payload data, test different scenarios, or override request values before they reach the server. We'll explore various use cases of modify request body rule, starting with how to create one. You can start creating rule directly from the homepage widget by clicking New Rule. However, for this demonstration, let's navigate to the Rules tab and click on the New Rule button, then select the type of rule you want to create. In this instance, modify request body, and then create the rule. Next, you can name your rule whatever you wish. For demonstration, we'll name it modify request body. You can also provide a description. Afterward, there is the source condition section. Here, you must input a keyword that matches the URL host or the path. You can specify the matching condition as either equals, contains, a regular expression, or a wildcard. For example, let's input airbnb.co in, then we'll click on the test icon to verify if the website matches the source condition. If the URL matches, you're good to go. Close this once done. Following that, there's a filter icon for filtering requests based on the page URL, resource type, and resource method. You can filter based on the URL of the page and its resource type, which might include XHR, JavaScript, CSS, images, etc. You can also filter the requests by methods, but let's leave it to the default for now, which will modify the body for all requests. In the request body, there are two methods to modify, a static one and a programmatic one. For a static request body, you simply pass a JSON that will entirely replace the payload. For a programmatic approach, you use JavaScript. In this demo, we'll use the static method. Create a sample body, like so. Pretty print is a feature you can use to format the JSON. After completing the setup, simply save the rule. After creating the rule, let's verify the process. Initially, the request has no payload. After applying the rule, click Test the URL. Now, every request should have the static body we defined. And there you have it. The requests now carry the static body we set up in our rule. Thank you for following this guide. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like, share, and subscribe.